Not in mics, sir. Already they are here.
Just to check the voice. Are you keep it there?
A very warm welcome to our dignitaries, both on and off the dais, and all delegates present here. Today we have Sri Rameshwar Teli, Honorable Minister of State, Food Processing Industries, Government of India, as our chief guest. On behalf of IFPT family, I welcome you, sir. We also have the privilege to have with us Sri S.S. Palanimanikam, Honorable Member of Parliament, Thanjavur Constituency. I welcome you, sir. Our guest of honor for the day is Dr. C.N. Ravishankar, the Director of ICAR, Central Institute of Fisheries Technology, Kochi. I welcome you, sir. Dear all, let us begin the auspicious occasion with Tamil Thai Valtu. I request everyone to stand. You may please be seated. The Indian tradition is very rich and the lamp holds immense importance in our cultural heritage. I now request all the dignitaries on the dais to kindly proceed for lighting the lamp. We hope that the brightness of lamp will illuminate our path for knowledge and prosperity. I now request our dynamic director, Dr. C. Ananda Ramakrishnan, to deliver the welcome address. Thank you so much, sir. Your views have enlightened us as always. Today we have Dr. C. N. Ravishankar as our guest of honor. Dr. Ravishankar joined CIFT Kochi as a scientist in 1991. He's an acclaimed scientist, has more than 200 international and national publications to his credit, and has filed 17 patents as of now. He has been bestowed with Outstanding Team Research Award in the field of fish products technology from ICAR New Delhi, K. Chidambaram Memorial Award from Fisheries Technocrats Forum, and many more. I now request Dr. Ravishankar to address the gathering. Thank you so much, sir, for your inspiring speech. Sri S.S. Palanimanikam, the Honorable Member of Parliament, is an active Indian politician from Tamil Nadu. He had been a member of parliament for 5 times, winning 5 continuous elections starting 1996. He was also the Minister of State in the Ministry of Finance from 2004 to March 2012. His interests are towards working for the upliftment of weaker sections of the society and has special interests in rural education and upliftment of the rural youth. IFPT is honored with your presence, sir. I now request Sri Palanimanikam to address the gathering. Thank you so much, sir. Today in this National Conference on Emerging Techniques in Food Processing, we'll be covering various aspects of recent trends in food processing, such as 3D printing of food, nanotechnology in food systems, non-thermal plasma processing, ultrasound processing, UV applications, and many more. The conference gathering is more than 500, consisting of delegates from several colleges and institutes from all over India. It's our privilege to have Honorable Minister of State, Food Processing Industries, Government of India, Sri Rameshwar Teli, as our chief guest. He has been a member of the Committee on the Welfare of Other Backward Classes in 2016. He was earlier a member of the Standing Committee on Human Resource Development, as well as the Consultative Committee for Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation under the Ministry of Urban Development. Now I request Sri Rameshwar Teli to release the conference proceeding CD, and I request Honorable Minister to please hand over the proceeding to Honorable MP, sir. थैंक यू सर अभी मैं माननीय मुख्य अतिथि से इस सभा को संबोधित करने के लिए आग्रह करती हूँ धन्यवाद सर आई शैल नाउ प्रोवाइड द एसेंस ऑफ द स्पीच टू द ऑडियंस Then I'll read the speech, sir. Then I'll read the speech, his speech. That I'm not reading. This brings us to the end of the inaugural ceremony. I request Dr. M. Loganathan, Professor and Head of Academics and Human Resource Development, IFPT, to deliver the vote of thanks. I request all to rise up for the national anthem. Please remain standing till the dignitaries leave the hall.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
A very good morning to all. We are about to start our inauguration ceremony. I request all to take their seats. Please keep your mobile phone switch off or in silent mode. Thank you. I request all to rise up since the dignitaries are arriving. very warm welcome to our dignitaries, both on and off the dais, and all delegates present here. Today we have Sri Rameshwar Teli, Honorable Minister of State, Food Processing Industries, Government of India, as our chief guest. On behalf of IFPT family, I welcome you, sir. Our guest of honor for the day is Dr. C.N. Ravishankar, the Director of ICAR, Central Institute of Fisheries Technology, Kochi. I welcome you, sir. Dear all, let us begin the auspicious occasion with Tamil Thaivaazhthu. I request everyone to please stand. The Indian tradition is very rich, and the lamb holds immense importance in our cultural heritage. I now request all the dignitaries on the dais to kindly proceed for lighting the lamb. We hope that the brightness of lamp will illuminate our path of knowledge and prosperity. Now I request our dynamic director, Dr. C. Ananda Ramakrishnan, to deliver the welcome address.
Respected Honorable Minister of State, Ministry of Food Processing Industry, Sri Rameshwar Teli, sir. And Dr. Ravishankar, Director SIFT Cochin, my colleague Dr. Loganathan, all the invitees, students, media friends, good morning to everyone. Really, it is an honor to be there today to welcome everyone for this wonderful conference. And the journey begins the very 50 years we celebrated last year, and today we come to the level we wanted to do it still furthermore. And that great occasion, we have the wonderful chief guest, our own Ministry of Food Processing Industry, our own minister has come all the way from Delhi to here. And very short notice, we told, is it possible to come? Sir accepted. Till yesterday, 4 o'clock, sir was there in the, minister was there in the parliament. And 4 to 7 o'clock, minister was attended so many meetings at ministry. And 7 o'clock started from the ministry, travel to Chennai, reached Chennai at 2 o'clock, by road Chennai to Tanjavur, traveled, reached 6 o'clock to Tanjavur, and come to 10 o'clock to the institute. It's a great commitment from the one minister to come to this far here. Thank you so much, sir. Really, we are how to say thanks or our gratitude to you, we don't know that. And we know that it is Tanjavur is not that access to the any of the place, but sir has taken such a pain and took the charge very within a month time to come over to the institute. It is not come from our side invitation. First, minister himself is asked, I wanted to visit. 15 days back, I given the small presentation to Honorable Minister about what we are doing in our IFPT center and Gaugati center and Bathinda center. Immediately, minister told, I like to visit your center. And within another 15 days, today he is there. Thank you so much, sir. And now I request Dr. Suresh Kumar, Professor, to welcome our minister with the flower of bouquet. Next, today our guest of honor, Ravi Sangha sir, and we want a Ravi Sangha sir for last Golden Jubilee celebration in the same hall, and somehow we missed because of the Kerala flood that time. Sir could not travel from the Kerala to here, and wherever I will meet, I will tell him, sir, please come. And he said, next time definitely I will come, but today such an occasion, he has come over here, and really we humbly thanks to you, sir, and to come over from all the way from Cochin to the IFPT, and we wanted to do a lot of work with you, sir. Now I request Dr. Vengarajalapathy to welcome Dr. Ravi Sangha sir with the flower of bouquet. If you look at IFPT journey, it is started with the very, very humble beginning of one scientist, the hunger scientist, Dr. V. Subramaniam, started this institute with his retirement money. Now where it is grown this much, even what he dreamed when he started, we don't know that, but we wanted to fulfill that dream. What would be there? We don't know that, but still we are running behind his dream. And today the IFPT has taken so many transformations, and whatever it is, last 3 years, we put the onion mission program that is transformed all onion growing farmers of 5 district here. That technology has reached so many places now. And what we invented, that integrated onion processing machine or onion flaky, onion powder paste, now reached even London Tesco. That is the power of the science. We taken the science into the grassroots level. That is the what IFPT started doing it. The confident what we got it from the Onion Mission program, we started Coconut Mission program. And we launched the Coconut Mission program. And now you can visit coconut tapping, Neera tapping machine. It is placed in the coconut tree itself. Automatically cuts the sap, and we can collect the Neera bottom of the tree. After this event, you can go and see that how it is wonderfully runs. It runs with the solar. And very soon it is going to be given to all the farmers who are growing the coconut trees. Not only that, we converted the coconut Neera into the Neera sugar, crystal, coconut chips, so many product, and already we transfer the technology. We are not stopped that one. Very soon, and another 2 months time, we are going to open Neera bottling plant at IFPT. All the coconut growers around IFPT, even Tamil Nadu, they can tap the Neera, they can bring the Neera to the institute. They can bottle the Neera, they can take, because that cost more than 1 crore to install that. So already we installed that bottling plant and processing plant at IFPT. August 15th, that will be ready. September 16th, coconut integrated unit also will be ready for making the virgin coconut processing unit. Both are ready to use by all the farmers in and around Delta region farmers. This is the one example. People have come over here with the 10,000, 20,000, now become entrepreneurs. Some of the entrepreneurs are today with us today, here. And not only that, that creates a lot of employments. And now we have taken the decision of every month, one unit IFPT will open. That unit, if already we have done last month, one unit we opened. And that is the transformation we want. And that generates a lot of employment, local employment. And till date, 98 entrepreneurs we have done. At a very short, another two we need to fulfill, and we need to go beyond that. That's what now we are working with Ministry of Food Processing Industry, along with the World Food. And we wanted to take all these small and medium and cottage level industry to grassroots level. Already World Bank is decided to fund 3,000 crore and 1,500 crore from the Ministry of Food Processing. And IFPT is the technical partner to that. And we wanted to take each district and each grassroots level to make such a processing unit in the very strong level. And today, why the conference for emerging technologies in food processing? I said earlier, IFPT transformed so many phases. Initially, it is built for catering to need of the Delta region farmers of paddy processing farmers and rice millers. Later, when we decided to move on to not only for paddy, all the crops, we moved to the Indian Institute of Crop Processing. Then we expanded our scope for all the food, including meat, fish, poultry. But that is not going to be enough. We wanted to be leader in food processing sector. That's what all the emerging technology we need to bring into the our system. That's what this conference has been planned. Look at what are the technology right now is emerging technologies. Food nanotechnology. It is one of the leading areas in the food science and technology. Almost, if you look at food nanotechnology, $100 billion last year business. And growth rate is 25%. No other segment is growing such a rapid pace. But India, still now, we are not able to give cater to that segment. So that's what today our Honorable Minister is going to inaugurate India's first nanoscale processing unit. And it can be processed nanoscale powders and span. And not only that, next lab, all the characterization of the nanoparticle, including the same XRD and DSC particle size analysis. Today we are going to open to help nanoprocessing industries in India. And 3D footprinting. First time in India, we opened a full-fledged lab on 3D printing of the foods. And all other institutions looked at how to make a 3D printing foods. Now we have made the 3D printer itself, that machine itself. Now present 3D printing machine cost around 10 lakhs plus. We made the 3D printer cost is only 20,000 rupees. Coming September 16th, we are going to launch that 3D printer. And this printer not only prints common, like what is the gel and other things. We have taken the all waste stream. We know that how much amount of the waste is generated in our country. We've taken the rice mill waste, 30% waste in the rice mill, pulse mill, 28% waste, fruits and vegetable, 25% waste. All we have taken, we converted in the flour with the help of PepsiCo, UK, and Nottingham University, and Siddha Starch. And already product has been made and launched by the PepsiCo, UK. But we converted that flour into the other product, including printable 3D printing material. And we added the iron and protein and other things, supplement to that. And even we're planning to install this 3D printer in the schools. And when kids come out from the schools, they can print whatever they want at shape, whatever they like the shape with that nutrient. That is the aim of our institute. And we are planning to do it in the September 16th. That is the target we fixed when our Founders Day we are going to celebrate. Not only that, if you look at big data analysis, blockchain, today 2-3 lectures are there. You can know that how that industry is moving very fast in this segment. We need to work out this one. IoT. Already IFPT working with the IoT network. Presently, we deployed 100 sensors in Guwahati, Bathinda, and Madurai. We are tracking our storage godowns. What is happening in the storage godowns? What is the temperature, moisture? All the signals what we are getting from that storage godowns, we can monitor from our mobile app itself. All the modeling and mobile app, everything's developed by IFPT. Coming 26th July, we are going to release that technology in the same flow with the DBT secretary. And that changes the lives of all the storage people, because 10% of the loss is happening in the storage. If moisture is taking more than 14%, how to monitor that? This we can do. What is the help this will help to institute like IFPT or Government of India? We have the big data. Everybody uses this mobile app. We generate the data will be there with IFPT. We know what is happening in Guwahati, what is happening in Punjab, what is happening in Orissa, all the place, our storage ground, we can monitor from the IFPT. That is the area we need to look. That's what we are moving very fast in the big data analysis. And today, exclusive computational modeling lab is going to be inaugurated by the Honorable Minister. And there we can study the, not only for that, modeling of the food processing, IoT, and blockchain systems. And blockchain systems adapted by other industry very fast. But one industry we have to adapt very quicker than others, because traceability is important. Who is the owner of adulterant? That big question mark. How to call back the product? So only blockchain techniques only can give it. So that is already we started working on that. Two workshops has been conducted. Now we wanted to expand that blockchain process. Not only that, non-thermal processing. We are going to set up exclusive center of non-thermal processing in IFPT, including HPP, pulse electric, all the system will be there within a year time. That is the aim of this institute. We are moving very fast with the help of Ministry of Food Processing Industries, Honorable Minister and Honorable Minister of State and Secretary. Thank you very much, one and all, for coming out to the IFPT. Enjoy the conference, wonderful speakers, and we'll share the knowledge and we'll see that what our country need, how and how to use this technological upgradation in the coming years. Once again, welcome to IFPT.
Thank you so much, sir. Today we have Dr. C. N. Ravishankar as our guest of honor. Dr. Ravishankar joined CIFT Kochi as a scientist in 1991. He is an acclaimed scientist, has more than 200 international and national publications to his credit, and has filed 17 patents as of now. He has been bestowed with Outstanding Team Research Award in the field of fish products technology from ICAR New Delhi, K. Chidambaram Memorial Award from Fisheries Technocrats Forum, and many more. I now request Dr. Ravishankar, sir, to address the gathering.
Thank you. Adarniya Mantri Mohoday, Sri Rameshwar Teliji, the director of this premier institution, and my friend, Dr. Ananda Ramakrishnan, and all the, you know, stalwarts in the scientists, the faculty, the teachers, in the seafood and the food industry, and all the industry representatives, all the faculty of IIFPT, and my dear students. Sabiko namaskar, ellarku vanakkam. First of all, let me apologize to Dr. Ananda Ramakrishnan for not coming earlier. In fact, I have been trying to come here for a couple of times, but unfortunately, there's some reason or the other, I could not come here, and so sorry for that. And let me first thank him for inviting me to this important seminar when we are talking of advances in food processing, preservation, packaging, application of thermal, non-thermal techniques and all that. First of all, let me hearty welcome the minister again. You know, he's such a simple man. We were just talking, we just met him briefly in the morning. Such a down-to-earth person. And so nice to talk to him, approach. And also, when I heard Dr. Ananda Ramakrishnan writing, you all know that the parliament session is going on, and you can imagine that is just the, you know, starting of the government formation, so much of meetings are going on, and so many new schemes are being implemented. And food processing sector itself, the government is giving so much of impetus. Even the Honorable Minister, Madam, I've met her, I've heard her a couple of meetings in IU First, I heard her. A tremendous energy, some tremendous, enthusiasm to develop this sector. So in that occasion, Honorable Minister taking time to visit this premier institution is something really wonderful. And maybe, even though I belong to another ministry, maybe agrah karta hun, anurodh karta hun, or request karta hun minister se, ye sector ko aapka guidance chahiye, aapke support chahiye, sir. Aur hum bahut kuch kar sakte hain. और ये खाली आईआईएफपीटी का नहीं है, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्रीज का नहीं है, हमारा मिनिस्ट्री एग्रीकल्चर है. सो आई बिलोंग टू आईसीआर फैमिली, माय कोलीग इज आल्सो हियर फ्रॉम इंजीनियरिंग भोपाल इंस्टीट्यूट. सो वी आर ऑल हियर टू वर्क टुगेदर अक्रॉस द मिनिस्ट्रीज, बिकॉज आईआईएफपीटी मे बी कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन लॉट ऑफ अदर फूड प्रोडक्ट्स, माई इंस्टीट्यूट कॉन्सेंट्रेट्स ऑन फिश, सी फूड्स एंड द फ्रेश वाटर फिश एंड ऑल दैट. So we can also work together, because there's no point in duplicating the facility. And you know, any technology, whether it is high pressure, whether it is PEF, whether it is radio frequency, whether it is IR, anything you take, irradiation, any technology you take, simple chilling, freezing, canning, it applies to many of the food products. Only thing we need to optimize for different products, okay? So it is only the optimization of the process parameters, optimizing the packaging requirements, optimizing the storage conditions, those things only are important. Whether it is for the meat, whether it is for the vegetable products, whether it is for the seafoods, I think we can work across. I am very happy to note that IIFPT is doing a great work. So on this occasion, I would like to give a big hand to Dr. Ananda Ramakrishnan. You know, I know this institution from long time, and I would like to remember Dr. Alagasundaram on this occasion, because he is my senior in the family of ICR now. He is our Deputy Director General in Engineering and holding another additional charge also. So we know him very, very closely. So he was instrumental in, you know, putting a lot of, you know, the infrastructure here. And where he left, Dr. Ananda Ramakrishnan has taken off, you know, excellently. So give him a big hand, I'll tell you. See, the, you know, the visibility of this institution, the vibrancy of his leadership, I see him so moving around from everywhere, talking to everybody, connecting people, bringing in collaboration. That's what is required for an institution like this. When we have student programs, definitely, you know, the visibility of the institution, collaborating with world-renowned institutions is always very, very important. So this institute has got a very good future. Recently, I had gone to the NIFTEM campus also. I think the support given by the ministry definitely will be, you know, taking this institution to greater heights. And, you know, the topics which we are talking of, big data analysis, 3D printing, you know, application of non-thermal technologies, all this is going to be the future. You know, when you talk of these technologies, you know, we still have a long way to go, because when we are talking of the nutritional security, food security, you know, reducing the post-harvest losses and applying, you know, appropriate technology to see that a safe food is reaching to the consumer, okay? Because we have a lot of limitations. You see, water is a limitation. And even any resource you see, there's a lot of, you know, even fish when I'm talking, the conservation of resource is becoming an important issue, okay? We are now exploited the oceans. So now we are concentrating from capture fisheries to culture fisheries. But when we are doing culture also, there is a limit, right? Because we have to go on adding a lot of other chemicals, you know, antibiotics. It's all becoming a health issue. You saw recently fish was supposed to be safe, but there was a lot of talk about, you know, addition of adulterants like formaldehyde, ammonia, to extend the shelf life. When we have a lot of techniques which are safe for extending the shelf life, why going for, you know, some of the chemical use, adulteration, which are harmful to our, you know, health? So when we are talking of safety, ensuring the safety, you know, application of these processes, whether it is a thermal processing or a non-thermal processing, assumes a lot of importance. An institution like this doing a great work in this area, I think this should be, you know, strengthened. I'm sure the government has taken a lot of keen interest, because whatever we have harvested, complete utilization of the harvested catch is very, very important, whether it is seafoods or any other commodity. You know, the perishables like fruits, vegetable, seafoods, we are losing a lot, you know, 10-15% post-harvest loss and the wastage of food. Even the morning also, the our Dr. Nachiket was telling to discussing with the minister. So these things have to be, you know, looked into, addressed into. So to reduce that, we need to employ an appropriate processing or preservation technology. You know, even you think of packaging, we have to minimize the packaging. We have to reduce the, you know, synthetic packaging materials. We should start going into the biodegradable or eco-friendly packaging materials. We have to employ, you know, green technologies. What we are talking is application of green technology, wherein you can reduce the post-harvest losses, preserve the, you know, the nutrients or whatever it is, and reach, see that it is reaching to the consumers. So that way, these seminars are very, very important. And I know morning also, I met a couple of faculty people who are going to talk about very, very high-end, you know, advanced technologies, which are already, you know, used in the Western world. I think we can always indigenize, you know, I think CFTRI, DFRL, and institute like CAFT, they're already working in several domain, these things. And here, it is a visibility for the, you know, students. And when I was talking to a couple of students in the campus also, they're all very, very excited. They're very happy to be here. I know the best faculty is here to teach the students. The best infrastructure is available. And with the new you know, innovations coming into the food processing industry, new facilities coming up in this campus, definitely we'll see that we reduce the post harvest losses, we increase the, you know, food usage and reach to the consumers. Because, you know, whether it is increasing our, you know, the infrastructure, reducing the post harvest loss, and also, you know, establishing a good cold chain, because perishables, that is a major concern in the country now. And also another point we'd like to mention about this is the entrepreneurship development. You know, the incubation center, what they have. And also, you know, he was talking of onion and so many value chain, you know, which has already been established, successfully given to the entrepreneurs. See, any technology which is developed in the lab, it should reach to the land. So that only it is, you know, useful. Whatever we are doing, that will have the application and the use only when it reaches to the common man. And also at an affordable price. You know, we can't be advocating high pressure processing to a small entrepreneur. We should develop a technology appropriately, whether it is packaging or processing, to affordable to a common man, so that the product is reaching a consumer at a affordable price. So all these are very important. So I once again compliment to Dr. Ananda Ramakrishnan for doing a great work in this organization. And I'm sure this sort of seminars will be very useful for the students, for the entrepreneurs, to take home a message, and also they can come back and use the facility here and then become an entrepreneur. Because this incubation center, which I would like to mention one special thing about, is, you know, and all small entrepreneurs can walk into this organization, use the technology, brand it, and perfect the whole process. When he is confident that he has got a market, he can go and become, you know, start an industry. That's what is an advantage of a incubation center. So I wish all the success for the, you know, the efforts taken by the director and all the staff of this organization, teaching and non-teaching. And once again, I would like to request the Honorable Minister to support this organization and give full, you know, freedom for him to do some more better work. And also, on this occasion, we would like request you to visit institute like CIIE Bhopal and CIFT also. So, aapko swagat hai sir, hamara samsthan mein. Hum log saath milke kaam kar sakte hain. Once again, thanks for this opportunity. Once again, I must personally thank Dr. Ananda Ramakrishnan for calling me to this function. I wish the best for this seminar. Thank you. And Jai Hind. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir, for your inspiring speech. Today in this National Conference on Emerging Techniques in Food Processing, we will be covering various aspects of recent trends in food processing. The conference gathering is more than 500, consisting of delegates from several colleges and institutes from all over India. It's our privilege to have Honorable Minister of State, Food Processing Industries, Government of India, Sri Rameshwar Teli, as our chief guest for the conference. Sri Teli is an active Indian politician from Assam. He has been a member of the Committee on the Welfare of Other Backward Classes in 2016. He was earlier a member of the Standing Committee on Human Resource Development as well as the Consultative Committee for Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation under the Ministry of Urban Development. Now I request Sri Rameshwar Teli to release the conference proceeding CD, and I request Honorable Minister to please hand over the proceeding to the guest of honor. अब मैं आदरणीय श्री रामेश्वर तेली जी से कॉन्फ्रेंस प्रोसीडिंग सीडी का विमोचन करने के लिए निवेदन करती हूं। धन्यवाद सर। अभी मैं माननीय मुख्य अतिथि से इस सभा को संबोधित करने के लिए आग्रह करती हूँ। सर प्लीज।
नमस्कार। आज इस अवसर पर उपस्थित हमारे डायरेक्टर IFT के आनर राम कृष्णन जी और डायरेक्टर ICR रविशंकर जी, हमारे प्रोफेसर लोकनाथन जी, नेगी जी, नेसिकेटन जी, सुनील घोष जी, श्रीनिवासन जी, यहाँ उपस्थित हमारे साइंटिस्ट प्रोफेसर्स और छात्रा छात्राएं और मीडिया बंधु, सही बात है, मैं रात को करीब 2 बजे पहुंचा चेन्नई और चेन्नई से आते आते करीब 6 बज गया सुबह, और आके मैं सोचा कि मीटिंग शायद खूब टाइम से होंगे और मुझे वहाँ उपस्थित रहना पड़ेगा। तो जो भी हो, मुझे बहुत बार टेलीफोन किए थे कि तेली जी आप अगर आते हैं तो हमारे इस राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन में हमारा सम्मान बढ़ेगा, और मैंने कहा कि मेरा पार्लियामेंट चल रहा है, आज भी 3 लाइन हुई है, फिर भी मैं चला आया, क्योंकि मेरा पहला दौरा है, मैं किया हूँ तमिलनाडु में तंजूर में। मुझे अत्यंत हर्ष हो रहा है कि आज मैं इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फूड प्रोसेसिंग टेक्नोलॉजी तंजावुर, जो कि फूड प्रोसेसिंग मंत्रालय भारत सरकार के अंतर्गत कार्य करता है, मैं यहाँ उपस्थित हूँ। मुझे खुशी है कि इस संस्थान ने फूड प्रोसेसिंग में नवीन विधियों एवं वस्तु में शोध की उत्साहित करते हेतु इस राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन का आयोजन किया है। इस मधुर बेला में मैं भारत सरकार की तरफ से सबको हार्दिक अभिनंदन करता हूं। हमारा भारत एक कृषि प्रधान देश है, वो हम गर्व है कि हम विश्व के प्रमुख खाद्य उत्पादक राष्ट्र में से एक हैं। यद्यपि हरित क्रांति से पूर्व हमारे देश में खाद्य संबंधित कठिन समय आया है, परंतु आज हमारे वैज्ञानिक के परिश्रम के बलबूते हम अपने तारंकिक आवश्यकताओं के अतिरिक्त खाद्य निर्धारक भी हैं। भारत ने 2018-19 में 2,813.7 लाख टन खाद्य उत्पादन किया, जो कि 2017-18 के 2,774.9 लाख टन से अधिक है। भारत के खुदरा खाद्य का मूल्य 61 लाख करोड़ रुपये से भी अधिक है। खाद्य शक्ति के आधार पर भारत विश्व का दूसरा सर्वाधिक उत्पादक है। दूध, केला, आम, मसाले, दाल एवं अन्य वस्तु में भारत अग्रणी उत्पादक है, और खाद्य उत्पादकता, खपत, निर्यात एवं अनुमानित उन्नति में भारत विश्व के 5वां राष्ट्र है। ये सब तथ्य हम सब के लिए गर्व का विषय है। भारत सरकार ने किसानों को आय 2022 तक दुगनी करने के लक्ष्य निर्धारित किया है, परंतु इस पथ में कुछ कठिनाई भी है। फसल कटाई से उपरांत एक बहुत अधिक अन्न की मात्रा पर्याप्त एवं उच्च कोटि के फसल संरक्षण व्यवस्था के अभाव में खराब हो जाती है। इससे किसान को किसी का उचित मूल्य नहीं मिल पाता है एवं उनका विश्वास सरकार की स्कीम से उठने लगता है। एक अनुमान के अनुसार यह नुकसान फल सब्जियां में 10-20 प्रसिद्ध बागवानी उत्पादनों में 5-16% दूध मत्स्य अंडे में मांस में और 10-20 तक है जो कि अत्यंत दुखदायी है। प्रधानमंत्री जी के किसान संपदा योजना के अंतर्गत इन्हीं समस्याओं पर ध्यान केंद्रित करने का प्रयास किया गया है। 6000 करोड़ की लागत से बनी ये योजना किसानों की संपदाओं की रक्षा करने के लिए बनाई गई है ताकि हमारे किसान बंधु आर्थिक रूप से वंचित ना हो। किसान के आर्थिक सशक्तिकरण के लिए फूड प्रोसेसिंग को भी मुख्य भूमिका रही है, वो आगे भी रहेगी। फूड प्रोसेसिंग भारत का मुख्य विषय है एवं देश के अनुमानित 32% खाद्य क्षमता का हिस्सेदार है। फूड प्रोसेसिंग का मुख्य उद्देश्य किसी उत्पादन का उचित वैज्ञानिक प्रोसेसिंग करना है जिसके हमारे वर्तमान के गोदाम संबंधित कमियां दूर हो और निर्यात में सहायता हो। यह फूड प्रोसेसिंग का विषय भौतिक भौतिक शास्त्र, रसायन शास्त्र और जैव शास्त्र का मिश्रण विज्ञान है जिसमें कि गणितों के समीकरण का भी उपयोग है। यह एक परिवर्तनशील विषय है जहां नित्य नई खोज हो रही है। यह शोध हमारे और आपके खाद्य संबंधित ज्ञान को नया आयाम दे रही है जो कि हर्ष का विषय है। नवीन तकनीकी जैसे कि विकिरण विज्ञान, नॉन थर्मिनल आयोजन, नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी, कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशन तथा संबंधियों विषयों में गहराई से शोध किया जाता है। यह सभी आधुनिक फूड प्रोसेसिंग के भागीदार है एवं आने वाले समय में इनका बहुत उपयोग संभावित है। फूड प्रोसेसिंग मंत्रालय भारत सरकार इन विषयों को लेकर गंभीर है एवं वैज्ञानिक को सर्वदा नई खोज के लिए प्रोत्साहित करती है। भारत मंत्रालय ने इस विषय के मैनेजर 42 मेगा फूड पार्क का निर्माण निर्धारित किया है जिनमें 8 कार्य कर रही है। मंत्रालय 35% तक की औद्योगिक लागत प्रदान करती है। भारत ने दाम निर्धारण करने हेतु ऑपरेशन ग्रीन नाम का परियोजना भी प्रमोट किया है। नाबार्ड परियोजना में भारत को 2000 करोड़ का निवेश किया है एवं 14 बिलियन डॉलर का समझौता फूड वर्ल्ड फूड इंडिया के लिए हुआ है। इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फूड प्रोसेसिंग टेक्नोलॉजी तंजूर ने सर्वदा नवल तकनीकों एवं वस्तुओं पर ध्यान दिया है। इस संस्थान का प्रयास अत्यंत संतोषजनक है एवं यह राष्ट्रीय अंतर्राष्ट्रीय मंच पर अपनी एक अलग छाप छोड़ती है। संस्थान द्वारा निर्मित नारियल का नीरा, बजरे का आइसक्रीम, प्याज प्रसंस्करण जिसके प्याज का पाउडर पेस्ट एवं अन्य वस्तुओं गणित एवं गणक के आधार पर परियोजनाएं नैनो विज्ञान में अग्रणी आयाम यहाँ की वैज्ञानिक विविधताओं की दर्शाता है। संस्था के 2 केंद्र भटिंडा और गुवाहाटी में हैं जहाँ किसानों, उद्यमियों एवं छात्र जनमानस को फूड प्रोसेसिंग के विभिन्न तकनीकों की जानकारी एवं प्रशिक्षण दिया जाता है। इन केंद्रों से पंजाब, हरियाणा, राजस्थान, उत्तर भारत एवं बंगाल, नॉर्थ ईस्ट के सभी राज्यों को फूड प्रोसेसिंग संबंधित आवश्यकताओं को पूर्ण किया जाता है। IIFT ने पिछले 50 वर्ष में बहुमूल्य कार्य किया है एवं इसकी प्रतियोगिता सराहनीय है। हम सभी को इस संस्था से जुड़े संस्था से बड़े आशा है ताकि हमारे देश का नाम विश्व स्तर पर गर्व से लिया जाए। मैं संस्था के डायरेक्टर का आभारी हूं कि उन्होंने इस संस्था को एक प्रगतिशील संस्था बनाया एवं शोधकर्ताओं का भी आभार प्रकट करता हूं जिन्होंने देश के लिए उच्च कोटि का कार्य किया है। भविष्य में मैं आशा है कि संस्था और ऊंचाई को छुएगा एवं हम सभी के गर्व का कारण बनेगा। मैं अपनी और अपने मंत्रालय एवं माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी को और से इस राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन के सफलता का कामना करता हूं एवं आप सबको यहां उपस्थित होने के लिए एक बार फिर धन्यवाद देता हूं। मैं आशा करता हूं कि भारत के फूड प्रोसेसिंग का भविष्य अत्यंत गौरवशील हो एवं इस सम्मेलन से सभी गणमान्य लाभान्वित हो। जय जवान, जय किसान, जय विज्ञान, जय अनुसंधान। मैं आसाम से आता हूं और मैंने कहा कि मेरा उम्र जब 26 ईयर था, 26 साल था, तभी मैं विधायक बन गया था। मेरा परिवार में कोई पॉलिटिक्स नहीं करता था। मैं कोई आदमी एक आके मुझे कहा कि तेली जी मैं एक प्रॉब्लम में हूँ, मुझे हेल्प करना है। मैंने कहा मैं उस समय असम में सबसे ज़्यादा चाय होती है, आप लोग मालूम है इंडिया में जो चाय होती है 70% असम में होती है और असम का चाय वर्ल्ड में बहुत फेमस है। और चाय बागान का एक ट्रेड यूनियन एक यूनियन था, उस यूनियन से मैं जुड़ा हुआ था। और एक आदमी ने आकर कहा मुझे थोड़ा हेल्प चाहिए आपको, तो मैंने कहा मैं क्या हेल्प कर सकता हूँ। तो मैंने कहा एक जान पहचान के लोग है उसके पास चलते हैं और गया मैं और उस आदमी को बोला कि मुझे थोड़ा हेल्प चाहिए आपको, ये जो आदमी आया है इनको हेल्प कर दीजिए। तो उन्होंने कहा अभी आप क्या करते हैं। मैंने कुछ नहीं करता हूँ, मैं मेरा घर के पास तेल निकलता है ऑयल मिट्टी से जिसको क्रूड ऑयल कहा जाता है और मेरा टाइटल भी तेली है। तो लोग बहुत ऐसा भी सोचते हैं कि तेल निकलने के कारण शायद तेली लिखते हैं, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है। कि जैसे हमारे एक बहुत बड़ा नेता था राजेश पायलट, उन्होंने पायलट था इसलिए टाइटल भी पायलट था। तो मेरा तेली जो है मेरा घर के आसपास तेल निकलता है इसलिए नहीं तेली है, मैं तेल पेरने वाला तेली हूँ। नारियल से भी तेल निकालता हूँ, सरसों से भी तेल निकालने वाला तेली हूँ। तो उन्होंने कहा कि आप अभी क्या करते हैं। मैं कुछ नहीं करता हूँ, इस आदमी को हेल्प करना चाहिए। ठीक है आप, मैं एक पार्टी में हूँ जहाँ अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जैसा एक आदमी है जो भारत का प्रधानमंत्री, मुझे पॉलिटिक्स के बारे में इतना ज्ञान भी नहीं था। तो इस आदमी को अगर आप हेल्प करते हैं तो आप जो भी बोलिए करेंगे। तो उस तरह से उसने मुझे पार्टी में ज्वाइन करवाया था और 99 में और 2001 में ढूंढने लगा वो जिस जगह तेल निकलता था, जिस जगह मेरा घर था, उस विधानसभा में उस कंस्टिट्यूंसी में कौन इलेक्शन खेलेंगे। उस समय बीजेपी जो पार्टी था वो लोग सोचता था कि ये बिहारी मड़वाड़ी की पार्टी, कोई टिकट लेने वाला नहीं था। मुझे कहा कि आप खड़ा हो जाओ, मैंने कहा नहीं खड़ा होना है। तो जोर जोर से उसने खड़ा कर दिया, 2001 की बात है और मेरा उम्र उस समय 26 ईयर था और उस समय विधायक बन गया मैं। असम में 126 सीट है जिसमें जिस आठ सीट तो मैं भी विधायक बन गया वहाँ। मेरा उम्र उस समय सिर्फ मेरा दाढ़ी ओढ़ी उस समय अच्छा से निकला ही नहीं था, मैं विधायक बन गया था। उनके बाद 2006 में भी जीत गया, 2011 में हार जाने के बाद मैंने सोचा कि और पॉलिटिक्स नहीं करना है जीवन में और कुछ करना है, बिजनेस करेंगे। लेकिन ईश्वर की कृपा थी, फिर 14 में फिर मुझे टिकट दे दिया गया, मैं फिर भी जीत गया। फिर 16 में मैं भी जीत गया, 19 में और ईश्वर की कृपा से मंत्री बन गया। तो असम या नॉर्थ ईस्ट जैसे कहा गया कि नॉर्थ ईस्ट प्रधानमंत्री के हर एक जो भाषण होता है उसमें कहा जाता है कि नॉर्थ ईस्ट जाना चाहिए। एक सुंदर जगह है नॉर्थ ईस्ट जहां हमारे जो फूड प्रोसेसिंग के काम बहुत ज़्यादा हो सकता है वहां नॉर्थ ईस्ट में। वहां फल मूल बहुत ज़्यादा होते हैं और जैसे कहा गया है कि 15% डैमेज हो जाते हैं, नष्ट हो जाते हैं। तो नॉर्थ ईस्ट में ज़्यादातर नष्ट हो जाते हैं क्योंकि वहाँ कोई कोल्ड स्टोर है नहीं, और ऐसा ऐसा चीज है जो अभी शायद जो लैब हम उद्घाटन करने वाले हैं, तो मैं भी चाहूंगा कि लैब में मेरा भी नॉर्थ ईस्ट के दो तीन ऐसा फल है कि उसको इस लैब में उससे क्या फायदा होता है जरूर हमें भी जानकारी होना बहुत जरूरी है। जो मिर्ची है शायद वर्ल्ड में कहीं नहीं है, ऐसा एक मिर्ची मिलता है नॉर्थ ईस्ट में आसाम में जिसको हम लोग भूट जलकिया बोलते हैं, भूट जलकिया, वो छूने से ही आपका जलने लगेगा। तो इसका अभी हम लोग बाहर में इंडिया के बाहर में हम लोग सप्लाई कर रहे हैं आसाम से, तो उसका भी एक रिसर्च होना चाहिए कि मैं चाहूँगा कि शंकर जी इसका ऊपर भी एक रिसर्च हो, ये मर्चा से ये भूट जलकिया से क्या क्या हमारा फायदा हो सकता है, क्योंकि हमारा कोई रिसर्च नहीं हुआ है अभी, लेकिन इसका इंटरनेशनल मार्केट में इसका बहुत वैल्यू ज़्यादा है। उसी तरह से ब्लैक राइस असम में होता है, ब्लैक राइस मैं मुझे पता नहीं कि तमिलनाडु में या हमारा इधर होता है कि नहीं, ब्लैक राइस होता है वहाँ। उसका बाद जो हम लोग हल्दी बोलते हैं वो ब्लैक हल्दी भी होता है उधर। तो इस तरह से ऐसा ऐसा चीज जो नॉर्थ ईस्ट में है और इसका इंटरनेशनल मार्केट में बहुत डिमांड है, तो हम लोग भी चाहते हैं कि इसका रिसर्च हो और लोगों को हम लोग बता सकते हैं कि ब्लैक राइस खाने से क्या फ़ायदा होता है या भूट जलकिया खाने से क्या फ़ायदा होता है, ब्लैक जो हल्दी है उसको खाने से क्या क्या फ़ायदा होता है, इसे लोगों को जानना चाहिए। तो मैं चाहता हूं कि अभी हम कुछ देर बाद जो लैब हम लोग उद्घाटन करेंगे, तो मैं डायरेक्टर साहब से अनुरोध करूंगा कि मैं उसका सैंपल मैं खुद भेज दूंगा और उसका रिसर्च हो, ये मैं डायरेक्टर जी से रिक्वेस्ट रहेगा। और पूरा इंडिया में फूड प्रोसेसिंग के काम जोर दूर से अभी हम लोग करने वाले हैं। अभी हम लोग वर्ल्ड बैंक से हम लोग 3,000 करोड़ हम लोग ले रहे हैं, जिसमें 70,000 उद्यमों को हम लोग लोन देंगे। तो डायरेक्टर साहब को मालूम है, और नवंबर 1, 2, 3 दिन हम लोग वर्ल्ड फूड इंडिया मनाने जा रहे हैं। तो मैं ज़रूर यहाँ शायद हमारे कैबिनेट मंत्री बादल मैडम भी इनवाइट करेंगे, हमारे यहाँ जो साइंटिस्ट हैं प्रोफेसर हैं सभी को। तो ये मैंने कहा और ज़्यादा नहीं कहना चाहता हूँ, आज ही मुझे निकल जाना है। मैं अभी मदुरई जाऊँगा, मदुरई से फिर मुझे चेन्नई जाना है, चेन्नई से कलकत्ता कल सुबह पहुँचना है, कलकत्ता से फिर असम, डिब्रूगढ़ में मेरा घर है असम, जहाँ मेरा घर जहाँ है दुलिया जान बोलते हैं, सेकेंड कुवेट कहा जाता है क्योंकि कुवेट ऑयल वहाँ निकलता है। और इंडिया का पहला रिफाइनरी जब ब्रिटिश के शासन थी उस समय इंडिया का नहीं नॉर्थ एशिया का फर्स्ट रिफाइनरी मेरा क्षेत्र में है, 1991 में वो रिफाइनरी बनाया गया था। उस जगह का नाम है डिग बॉय, डिग मतलब खोदना, बॉय मतलब लड़का, तो ब्रिटिश का नाम है। और वो रिफाइनरी के पास ही मेरा घर है, तो मुझे जाना है कल। और तो आज आप लोग यहाँ मुझे बुला के जो स्वागत किया उसके लिए मैं इंस्टीट्यूट के सभी लोगों को मेरी तरफ से धन्यवाद करता हूँ, और इतने करके मैं अपना वक्तव्य समाप्त करूँ। जय हिंद।
धन्यवाद सर। आई शैल नाउ प्रोवाइड द एसेंस ऑफ द स्पीच टू द ऑडियंस। द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट हैज वेलकम्ड ऑल द डिग्निटरीज विजिटिंग IFPT फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर इंडिया। ही हैज हाईलाइटेड इंडियाज फ्रंट लेवल पोजिशन इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फूड ग्रेन्स, हॉर्टिकल्चरल क्रॉप्स, मिल्क, पोल्ट्री, फिश एंड मीट प्रोडक्ट्स, एज वेल एज द ग्रोथ ऑफ इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर इन 2018-19। Minister sir has also emphasized on looming adversities of post-harvest losses in India and shared his concerns about reduction in usable agri-produce export and farmers' income due to these factors. He emphasized about the importance of food processing in today's scenario. Sri Teli has deliberated on various schemes of Government of India such as Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana and Operation Greens, besides several programs of MFPI to help farmers and different food processing sectors. Minister sir has also expressed immense pleasure in acknowledging IFPT and its satellite units' congregated performance in food processing techniques, formulating highly nutritious millet ice cream to onion program, to advances in computational modeling and nanotechnology, to nutritious products with NIRA and the upcoming field of 3D printing. Besides manpower training, he acclaimed the performance to be commendable. Sri Teli has welcomed the farmers and entrepreneurs of Northeast India to get help from the Institute's liaison office at Guwahati, where they can get training on various aspects of food processing. The minister also added that IFPT has made remarkable progress in the past 50 years and along with its liaison offices is still making laudable progress in all areas of food processing engineering. He expressed his wish to witness many more useful technologies or products being developed by the Institute for the Nation and mankind in the near future. He wished the conference a great success. Sir has also shared his life story with us, which is very inspiring, and requested IFPT to come up with detailed knowledge on vegetables and herbs available in Northeast India. This brings us to the end of the inaugural ceremony. I request Dr. M. Logarathan, Professor and Head of Academics and Human Resource Development, IFPT, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Most respected dignitaries on the stage, up the stage, faculties and dear students, good morning to all. So today is a very important day for IAPT because we have our young and energetic Honorable Minister of State, Ministry of Food Processing Industries with us. So thank you for your presence here and inaugurating this conference and also for sharing your experience with us. So we assure that IAPT will be with you for achieving your goals and dreams for next 5 years. So as a token of love, we would like to present a memento. Now I request our director to present a memento to our Honorable Minister. On behalf of IAPT family and participants, I thank our guest of honor, Dr. Ravi Shankar sir, who is all the way from Cochin. So thank you for your presence and sharing your experience and knowledge with us, sir. So I request our director to present the memento to our guest of honor, Dr. Ravi Shankar sir. So we have eminent speakers, there is delegates with a lot of experience on food technologies from various organizations across the country. So I thank all the delegates who are all coming from various organizations with lots of effort to present here. So on behalf of IAPT, I thank all of them. And I thank all the participants, students from various colleges and universities and also from industries for participating in this conference and be here and be with us for another few hours to get more knowledge from our eminent speakers. And I also thank all the media and I thank our organizers, faculties, students, and who are all directly or indirectly involved in organizing the conference successfully. Thank you and all.
Thank you, sir. I request all to rise up for the national anthem.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanka Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchchala Jaladhi Taranga Tava Shubha Name Jage Tava Shubha Aashish Mange Gahe Tava Jaya Gatha Janagana Mangala Dayaka Jaya He Palaka Bhagya Vidhata Jaya He Jaya He Jaya He Jaya 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 He.
Please remain standing till the dignitaries leave the hall.